It's not every day that a fast food company and one of the world's largest gaming developers asks you to build a 7.5 foot tall cardboard monster. On a personal note, I'm super stoked for this project. I've been a huge Soul Calibur fan since the original Soul Edge. We're gonna be building a full-scale nightmare from Soul Calibur 6 for Anime Expo out of cardboard. Our first step is to kind of get used to this material. We don't work in cardboard that often. Most of our projects are built out of high-end urethanes, silicones, we coat it in automotive paint, we spend a lot of time sanding, getting a perfect finish. This has got to be built out of what is effectively packaging material. This whole project is being modeled by a really talented 3D artist, Travis Wood over at Wooden Leg Studios. He's actually our next door neighbor. Travis is going to be taking Nightmare and modeling him out fully in a program called ZBrush. And then he's taking that and dropping the poly count way, way, way down. This thing will eventually be very broad, flat shapes. It'll be very angular. And we're gonna take that model and we're gonna put it into a program called Pepakura. Pepakura will take a complex 3D model and flatten that geometry out into a series of flat planes. From there, we can take those patterns created by that program, throw this thing into our laser cutter, and that can laser cut all of our base shapes. That's gonna save us a ton of time on this. It does half cuts through all the cardboard, and we can use that as fold lines. We end up with sort of these tube shapes with a lot of half cuts through the material, and that makes it really bendy and flexible. So what we have to do now is reinforce the whole thing. We're gonna take each one of the pieces we've constructed so far, the arms, the legs, the helmet, the chest, reinforce the interior of each of those with a really high strength epoxy that we're gonna brush in. That's gonna soak into the cardboard, give the interior of each of these parts a big thick shell. That's gonna make everything way stronger, and it'll also reinforce all those under pieces so we can add detail to them later without worrying about bending, flexing, or destroying them. What we're gonna do from here on is take the Arby's packaging, cut some red strips out, cut some brown strips out, a few small accents here and there in yellow, and use that to detail all these pieces to make them look more like the whole thing is built completely out of Arby's packing material. The laser cutter on this project was a godsend, and it came in really handy when we had to create complex parts like Nightmare's chainmail and ringmail around his waist and his arm, as well as his small accent areas like the eagles on his hips and helmet. We're able to get stuff really, really precise and detailed without spending hours cutting it by hand. Sort of fitting with the theme of this whole cardboard build, we're using hot glue to tack everything together. We actually ended up buying 5 different hot glue guns to get all this done. It saves us a ton of time. We have 2 weeks to build the whole thing. We gotta make sure glue dries very quick. Another trick we're using to save time is blasting our larger or thicker hot glue joints with some compressed air. Anybody who's ever glued hot glue together knows you can kind of blow on it for a second to get it to cure faster. We're just doing that with a 100 PSI compressor. In order to meet our deadline, we can't just go part to part to part. We're building every single piece of Nightmare simultaneously. It's all gonna come together right at the end into one giant sculpture. It's easy to say that Nightmare is the villain in Soul Calibur, but the real villain in Soul Calibur is the sword Soul Edge. And building Nightmare's Soul Edge is like building another character entirely on its own. We can't really pattern that out in Pepakura. There's a lot of muscly, sinewy, meaty-looking elements, and that's gonna be sculpted on by hand. To make sure that the sword could support its own weight, we put a steel bar that runs the entire length of the blade all the way up into the top of the handle. For the metallic effect on the blade, we used Arby's sandwich wrappers cut into strips and then spray-mounted onto the blade. This stuff is insanely fragile. It's not really meant as a build material, so we had to be very, very careful when applying it so that you don't rip the foil off of the paper backing. For the eye on Soul Edge, we went back to Pepakura and laser cut a sphere out of very low poly squares, assembled that into the eye shape with a concave iris to give it a little bit more depth and dimension. From there, we had the incredibly painstaking task of adding all the muscle structure around the eye. These were first created by twisting those same sandwich wrappers into sort of a slug type shape, gluing them down so that they looked sort of like sinewy muscle, and then taking tiny pieces of red Arby's sandwich packaging that are 1 to 1.5 inches long and tacking them down one by one until the entirety of that muscle structure was completely covered in literally thousands of tiny pieces of red cardboard. The arm is going to be similarly patterned, lots of small pieces of red to create a muscly texture, and then more of that brown cardboard flipped over, creating chitin plates and bone elements. We've got all the separate elements complete now. We have his legs, we have his torso, we have his butt and his head. Now we have to make it all into one nightmare instead of a pile of body parts. Nightmare's gonna be really tall. He's gonna be kind of top heavy. He's got that big sword. We need to create a way for him to stand up on his own. So we're creating a PVC skeleton that's gonna fit through his entire body. There's also two long PVC skis, is what we've called them, at the bottom that are filled with just spare nuts and bolts we had around the shop and then filled up with casting resin to create a heavy weighted base. From there, there are two uprights that slide through both of his legs. We actually made a sort of hip section for Nightmare. From there, we insert his spine and arm rig cross piece. Maybe, I guess you would call that his collarbone. The monster arm's a little bit harder to rig because at this point, we only can reach through his sort of neck hole to fit it into place. And then it's easy just to pop the head on. Nightmare is all together, the sculpture's done, and we've only got a couple of hours to appreciate it. He's gotta be in Los Angeles in a day. We're gonna have a crew at Anime Expo assembling Nightmare on show floor. So we're gonna take him apart now, put him back together a few times, rehearse that process, make sure that everybody knows what they're doing before we mail him out. It turns out shipping Nightmare is also a nightmare. They don't really sell boxes this size, so some of our scrap materials that was going to be used to build Nightmare is going to be used to ship Nightmare. We've made three enormous boxes, one for his body, one for his legs and arms, and then another for the entire sword. We had 2 weeks from start to finish to go from flat sheets of cardboard to a 7-foot-6-inch tall sculpture of Nightmare. At Anime Expo, Nightmare is actually being constructed on show floor while the convention is happening. Our artists are putting him together in front of an audience, and that audience is actually invited to participate in the construction of Nightmare. We have laser cut 500 small pieces of his tattered cape, and people attending Anime Expo can draw on those things, put their own notes, put their Twitter handle, and add to Nightmare as he's being constructed. It's really cool to finally get this thing on show site, put it up in front of people, and see the reaction. To see people geek out about it on social media, to see people flip out about Arby's building a 7-foot-tall Nightmare sculpture, to see people genuinely enjoy it. And our booth is going to be the only place at Anime Expo to play Soul Calibur 6. We actually have Soul Calibur, the original, on our Dreamcast in our break room here at the shop to be working with Bandai Namco for the release of Soul Calibur 6, which I'm really looking forward to, is just a huge honor. We had 8 people full-time working on Nightmare for 14 days straight in order to make sure that we had him out on this deadline, and everybody was necessary. Everybody made sure that this project would be perfect.